What's going on, gamers? Today we are going to go over how to install and use the Explorer's Compass mod in Minecraft. Before we get started, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all future videos. If you are used to exploring the game of Minecraft, then you're used to finding a ton of different structures. From simple villages to large mansions, they are always fun and beneficial to find, but it can be hard to track them down. This gets really difficult when you're trying to find something specific without using admin commands. This is fixed with the Explorer's Compass mod, a mod that allows you to select and track structures in your world. It is super easy to use and install with Apex, so let's go over how to do it. Visit the Explorer's Compass CurseForge page, and at the top of the page, press Files to view all of the versions. Press View All, and then use the drop-down menu to select Fabric or Forge, and then scroll down to look for the version that you want to download. Press the Download button to the right, and after that's done, save the file to a safe location like a separate folder, because we will need it again in just a minute. Head to your Apex server panel and stop the server. Scroll down to the Game File section and make sure you're running a matching version of Forge or Fabric for your mod. After this, enter the FTP file access on the left-hand side, log in, and then find or create the mods folder and enter it. Press Upload in the top left, and on the next page, drag and drop the mod file. Once it is 100% uploaded, you can click on your username at the top of the page to go back to the main panel, where you can restart the server to load up the mod. You're also going to have to install this mod on your client in order to start playing. First, make sure you have either Forge or Fabric installed on your computer, which we have guides to if you need to know how to do that. Afterwards, open up your Minecraft launcher, and then press Installations at the top. Hover over your installation, and then press the Open Folder button on the right-hand side. In the file browser that opens, find or create the Mods folder, enter the folder, and then paste the mod file here. Return to the Minecraft launcher, and then press Play. To get started, you'll first have to make the compass, which takes a few unconventional items that you may or may not have on hand. When you're ready, open a crafting table and use this recipe of 1 compass, 4 cobwebs, and 4 cracked stone bricks. After that's done, right-click the compass to open up the tracker menu. Here is where you'll find a variety of different buttons and options needed to use this mod. The main area of the mod is the structure list. Here, you can easily search for your desired structure, as well as information on where it's from, the group, and which dimension it's located in. To choose a structure, just click on it. The search and sorting buttons are used along with the structure selection. The sort button allows you to change the list order and change how it's displayed. The two search buttons will allow you to find the selected structure or the structure group. As the name suggests, the teleport button will allow you to teleport to the currently tracked structure within your world. This is only going to be available to players with admin access, so normal players won't be able to use this function. If you don't have admin access, then you can use the directions on the compass to make your way towards the structure. If you get an error when joining the server, this is often caused by an issue with the mods on your own client. Make sure that Minecraft Forge or Fabric has been installed alongside the Explorer's Compass mod to match the server before joining. If you can join the server but the compass isn't working, this issue mostly happens when the mods are properly installed on your own game, but they're not working on the server. First, make sure the server is running Forge or Fabric, and then visit the FTP file access. Enter the mods folder and check that the mods jar file is located in this folder. With Minecraft maps being so large and randomized, it's really hard to find specific things without commands or just a ton of roaming around until you happen to get lucky. That is no longer something you have to worry about with this mod, since a quick search will lead you right where you need to go. That's all for this one, gamers. As always, I hope you have lots of fun.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.